still no pressure. Thank God I breathe. Cause shit I speak is what they need. I tell no lies. I'm still up top and still can't drop what they not.
Alright, y'all. So we are currently hitting a volume chest today. Just like the last vlog you guys saw when I walked Nick through everything, I'm doing a volume stack. We were focused on strength beforehand, but we've changed up the training style a little bit. So I'll throw up the chest workout on the screen so you guys can see it. I'm not going to walk through it all. But we're doing anywhere from 10 to 12 reps or 10 to 15 reps with around 3 to 4 sets per superset. And it's only 1, 2, 3, 4 supersets. So it's super quick, in and out. I usually get it done in like 45 minutes to an hour, very quickly. And my body doesn't feel like too worn down, even though we are putting on size. Again, if you missed the last vlog, I'll show up the video where my current physique is. The vlogs are actually just 2 days apart. I filmed one yesterday, filmed one today. Today is all about walking you guys through what I do every single day. All right, again, as a 29-year-old billionaire running multiple businesses and training for my first fight, I'm super excited. We've already been up since 3 a.m. It's currently 4:43. Got to the gym at 4:30. All right, cranked out a bunch of shit, my entire morning routine, which I'll walk you guys through later on in the day, kind of explain why it's so important to me. We're just gonna keep grinding it right now. People say that muscles don't mean nothing in boxing, but I'd rather be a jack-box than a skinny little bitch, okay? Nobody intimidated by a fucking 120-pound dude with skinny-ass little arms. No fucking way. I might be 5'6", but I'm gonna be a thick 5'6".
Yeah.
Like every Tuesday, every bi-weekly Tuesday in our community, is I do a content audit call. What that means is I sit down with our clients for anywhere from 60 to 120 minutes, 1 to 2 hours, and I just audit their content based off of what I'm seeing at face value. Like, what's your profile look like? How's your profile photo? What's your name? What's your tagline? What's your bio? Is your content good? Is it shit? Do you need to open up more? Do you need to be more authentic? My whole goal is to hopefully give you some sort of inspiration and direction to help you with your business and make more fucking money online, because that's the goal of all of us, right? The reason why I do that call is because I fucking love it. Social media and content is one of my favorite things in the world. A lot of people don't love content audits because they get a bunch of advice they don't want to implement. But they also love it because then they actually get the advice they fucking need. So I'll show you guys that later.
Stop playing with a boss like that. I don't react well when you talk like that. Put the money on the phone, then call right back. I don't really want to do the small talk like that. Stop playing with a boss like that. I don't react well when you talk like that. Put the money on the phone, then call right back. I don't really want to do the small talk like that. Yeah.
I was here yesterday. There's 4 different kinds of like fucking ropes, fucking metal bars and shit, all just on the ground. And I was like, bro, it took me fucking 5 seconds to take all of them over.
Yeah. It just shows that like when you go to a gym and you don't put your weights away, it's just a blatant disrespect to the area itself and everybody else in it. You think you're better than everyone else. I promise you, you ain't. Unless you own the fucking gym, you should put everything away. Because if I own the gym and I put it away, why the fuck aren't you? One of the things that I noticed is that my left pec has always been lacking. It's on a smaller side out of both. So what I'm trying to do is my regular warm-up, 2 working sets, and then on my 3rd working set, what I'll do usually, again, there might be people who don't agree with this, but I don't give a fuck, is I'll lower the weight down, I will pre-burn out my left side, lock in my body, and then just do reps on the left side, and then I'll go double instead of unilateral, and burn out both instantly, because I'm trying to balance it out, meaning I need to exhaust the side that's fucking smaller first, because if I try to go bilateral in every movement, I'm just going to continue to fuck myself, and they're just going to build at the same time, so I'll lock myself in. By the way, you ever want a real good lighting photo for your physique? I'll show you the best place in the whole gym. Because it's not about looking good, it's just about knowing where to take the good photos.
Throw up the sex in a And I can put you in.
When I wake up at 3 a.m., I instantly get into a cold shower for anywhere from 2 to 5 minutes. Then I go into 5 minutes of affirmation journaling, 5 minutes of gratitude journaling. Then I go into my 5% core value list, where I look at my core values, I'll throw them up on the screen, and then I ask myself, how can I embody one of these by 5% more today? And it helps me align myself to who I want to be as a man, a provider, a motivator, a husband, a father, and way more. Now we got boxing. Okay, so we already finished up a workout today. We did an hour and 10 minutes of upper body, so a little bit of chest, a little bit of triceps, a little bit of shoulders. Now we're getting into fucking boxing. All right, this is the next thing that I do on a continual basis, all right, on a regular day. Today's actually a 2-hour session instead of an hour session, and I don't know what we're doing today. I just show up.
I usually plan our shit the night before on the toilet.
I like it, bro. Yeah.
And throughout the day, I'll like ideas kind of will come to me.
Yeah.
And then I'll look at what we did and kind of go over it. So we always have, I always have a plan, but then like, it's like, oh shit, we need more time on this. Then yeah, we just end up.
But it's mostly on the toilet.
Mostly yeah, on the toilet. So like, obviously we're joking around about that, but it's something that I'm actually very, very happy with. Like I said, like I just show up and like Jared tells me what to fucking do. That is something that I feel like a lot of individuals underestimate. Like, you guys underestimate the power of just having a coach that tells you what to fucking do. And I have it in everything.
Close it.
Right? Like I have a fitness coach. That's really good. That we're literally just going over my goals. Like I fucking just, Nick heard me talking to him because we're in a really good place weight wise. He's actually extremely happy. He's probably gonna up my food even more because when you up my food from 1700 calories to 1900, we dropped 3 pounds. So now we're maintaining a fucking 171. That's good. Yeah, that's good. All right, and I don't need to think about what I do. I just get my plan, I go to the gym, I do it. I show up, I look at Jared, he tells me what to fucking do. Like my, it removes decision fatigue from my fucking life. I just do the fucking work, and then it gives me way more mental energy to focus on the family, focus on my content, focus on my shit. All right, I've got a content coaches, boxing coach, fitness coach, all that shit.
Okay, we're just gonna, maybe with a warm up.
Okay.
We're gonna go light.
Mm-hmm.
If this is a little too much, we'll go to the paddles.
Okay.
But just keep it easy.
Yeah.
And just keep that form tight. Try not to get too loose with it, with the hands.
Okay.
Okay. Catch. Roll. Two slips. Block three.
I have one that one side.
Slip. Touch. Good?
Yep.
I'm gonna change with my shirt off when I get my dicks up. And she keep it in her throat like she got the hiccups. I ain't talk about no mouth though if we hit the lick up. I don't sell, I used to snort the dope in that brick up. I don't give a fuck about who's streaming, pull the list up. I'm a father.
Alright guys, so that is the beginning of the day. It is 8 a.m. I've done my entire morning routine. I've done a little bit of content planning. I've done an hour and 10 minute workout. I've done 2 hours of boxing and I've done 15 minutes of steady state cardio and it's fucking 8 a.m. How crazy is it that some people wake up at this time, Daniel? Mental, bro. So guys, today is a little bit busy. We got a couple meetings today. We've actually got 3 meetings, all right, a podcast and a call in the academy. So I'm gonna go shower and get ready because your boy stinks like shit. I also want to see my baby and my wife. So let's go see them right quick. And then we're gonna get into the meeting and shit.
Okay. Hi.
Pancakes right now. So guys, I'm gonna plan out what I'm supposed to be eating today. Unfortunately, I did not get Brian to make me food or order any meal prep for you, so I don't have any fucking food prep, so we gotta figure out what to eat right now.
Oh, you okay?
He's good.
On my rest days, he wants me eating 1,810 calories, 50 fat, 160 carbs, 180 protein, so super simple. And then on training days, basically like every fucking day, oh yeah, 200 grams carbs. 200 carbs, 60 fat, 180 protein, we're finally over 2,000 calories. I've been between 1,600 and 1,710 calories for like what, babe? 8 months? Right? Like for legit as long as we could fucking think about. But we're in a very good place physically right now. You guys saw it at the gym this morning. You saw it while we were training. You saw it with the transformation photos yesterday on the last vlog. So now we are fucking finally eating. And you know what that means? That means I can have cereal. I'm fucking stoked right now, bro. I'm gonna fucking have protein cereal. So what I'll do is usually for breakfast, I'll either have like protein pancakes for meal prep for you, or if I can, if the carbs will allow it, my favorite cereal, blueberry mini wheats, all right? Mixed with a protein shake. It's super simple, bro. As you guys can probably tell, cereal is a staple in this household. So what I do is I come down here, open up the monster fridge, take one of these protein shakes,
which are fucking also delicious. They are from Redcon One, so I took a vanilla one. And for two servings, it's 6 grams of fat, 6 grams of carbs, and 40 grams of protein. So I literally just dump one of these in the bowl with the serving of cereal, and that's my breakfast. Super simple. And then we got a meeting in fucking 50 minutes. Got the chick, I call it Lola. She feel like the ocean, like to drink and smoke some Doja. And I feel like smoking, plus she good at charming cobras. I feel like I'm chosen, but she ain't the only one, no. All right, guys, so that was a meeting I do with Janelle every Tuesday now. Janelle and Josh are my heads. So we have three coaching communities, the Change Lives Academy, the 10K Mastermind, and the Million Dollar Mastermind. And we have 12 coaches, all right, 12 coaches around there. Honestly, I had my hand in each group for a while, and I was running all of the coaches for a while, but it reached a point where we hired Dan Martell. He helped me start reading Buy Back Your Time. I reached a point where I wanted to start buying back my time, and I can't fucking do everything. I also don't like systems, all right? I like teaching, I love coaching, I love building, I love creating visions to scale something to the next level. I do not enjoy building systems. Josh does, Janelle does. So now Janelle is my right hand. She's the main coach that's underneath me to make sure that things are running smoothly. She is heading also the 10K and the Million Dollar Mastermind. And then Josh is my head in the academy to make sure that the coaches do what they're told and to make sure that they're all good and happy. Also, he's there to make sure that the academy runs smoothly so I can work on the business instead of in the business so we can scale to the next fucking level. Now your boy's got an ortho appointment, so I gotta go. I'll see you guys in a bit. It's dope having these cars. I'm not gonna lie. This garage is literally dedicated to me, right? Even though Julia bitched me up this morning because we woke her up at fucking 5:30 a.m. and then proceeded to piss her off from the boxing and laughing and loud noises in the cars, this is my fucking garage. We got boxing shit. We got Supercar One. We got a bunch of the clothing. Stay tuned. Amrock Aesthetics, link in fucking bio. And we got the fucking big boy Bertha. All right, big girl Bertha. This girl's name is Storm, and that one is Jane. All right, guys, so your boy went to his ortho appointment, and I don't have to wear fucking my retainer anymore. Unless it's at night.
That's dope.
There we go. So we're fucking in a good place. Super cool. I was actually telling Janelle and Josh about this. I got my braces again, I think it was like a year and a half ago. And I was supposed to have them on for 18 months. And I got them off in like 8.5 months, 9 months. So it's just super cool. Made me very happy. I had my gap for a very long time. And even though like it really never bothered me. Like when I was doing Instagram stories and like taking photos, it would never bother me. There would be random times it would bother me where I'd be like, see it, and I'd be like, oh, that really pisses me off. You know what I mean, Daniel?
Yeah.
I'm like, something doesn't bother you. You're like, okay, whatever, like it's fine. But then you'll catch a glimpse and you'll be like, oh, that bothered me that time. Like that bothered me that time. So it was like, wasn't a continuous thing, but it was a thing. And as soon as that happened, I was like, nah, this needs to change because I don't like living like that. So got my fucking teeth fixed. Your boy's excited. And now it's just relaxation time. All right, I'm gonna go eat some more food. I'm gonna go see what's upstairs. All right, once I find something to eat, I will show you guys, and then I'll go through the macro calculation, and then we have content on it, so it's gonna be lit. So it turns out that I don't have any fucking food in this house, because we are leaving tomorrow, so I didn't think to buy a bunch of fucking meal prep and shit. So I might actually end up having like a cheat meal at dinner tonight with Julia, which I'm super excited for. She doesn't know about it yet, but I know that she'll be down. So I just add one of these Builders protein bars, so the Clif bars, and let me just walk you guys through it, and I'll scan it on my fitness pal and give you guys a breakdown of this. So it's 31 grams of carbs, 9 fat, and 20 protein. With the breakfast I had this morning and the protein bar, I still have 1410 calories. Holy fuck, dude, that feels so good. It's not even funny, bro. I don't think you guys understand how good that fucking feels. Like starving. Dude, I've been fucking starving for months, and I've been grinding my fucking face off every single goddamn day. Daniel sees it. I'm like, literally, there'll be like times where I'm just like laying in my fucking office, like, oh my God, I feel like I'm gonna fucking die. Julia's relaxing right now, and Kate is asleep. I'm gonna go do a little bit of content planning, and I've actually got to do a little bit of admin work, for lack of a better term. We run a company that subcontracts 52 employees.
All right, we have subcontractors, not employees, that work with us, and it's a lot to manage. There's a lot of moving parts. There's a lot of emotions, all right, that people need to go through. I actually just got a text from an individual they need to talk to today. I'm not going to film that because it's something that I don't really want to air out there. I like to give everybody their respect and their distance when everything's happening like this. So I'll do this call, and I'll see you guys when we do our next breakdown. But this is a pretty fucking regular day for me, where it's like meeting, appointment, meeting, training my ass off, call. Like 11 a.m. I already feel like I've been fucking working all day. Like I feel like we've done a million things and it's only 11:02 a.m.
Last year I was in your gym and a couple people said that I stink and they kicked me out of the gym. Haven't been back since. I asked a couple of coaches for help on numerous occasions, was given one word answers, and was totally abandoned in the program.
If a client ever comes to me with a complaint or is angry or disgruntled, what I will do is I will go into the program, I will find all the posts they made, and then I will show them the proof of what they have said, all right, to me. So the first thing I want to address is I like to dive into these situations when they get brought to me, all right, when I figure out they're actually happening. So I want to dive into this right now. Number one, what do you mean you didn't get the support you were looking for? Is there something that I'm not seeing? The reason why I ask that is because in the last year, you have only made 13 posts. In 365 days, you have posted 13 times, unless I am missing something. And with that being said, on all the posts that you see above, you got 8+ comments, individuals giving you actionable advice to help you with whatever your question was. Not to mention, you didn't even implement the stuff for your Facebook profile, which was your cover photo and your profile photo and your description and everything else. So where is the lack in support? Was it actually a lack of support in the program, or were you just embarrassed that you got told to put deodorant on? Question mark. Work so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hate and say we changing, look, we made it. Yeah, so this is the thing, okay? The reason why I will tell all of you, that a business page is bullshit is because most of you guys haven't established yourself as a personal brand yet, and starting a business page is gonna be way too much fucking work. This is what I want all of you guys to think about if you decide to do a business page, all right? DIY Body is the only fucking business page that I would accept that you guys would create, and even with that, you don't need one. All right, all Dawn does is post testimonials here. Now, obviously, you got screenshots here. I would stop doing the stars, tell your clients you're gonna use their fucking photos. And let's say if a client, what's this client's name?
Caitlin.
All right, so Caitlin comes to you and she's like, I really don't want you to use my photos, right? And I'm like, okay, Caitlin, do you mind if I ask you a few questions about that? If you really don't want me to use your photos, I completely understand, but I'd like to ask you a few questions. Is that okay? Okay, listen, when you first started with me, you were incredibly insecure and you hated your body, correct? How do you feel now? Do you feel good?
Yeah, I feel amazing.
Do you feel confident?
Yes.
Okay, now what if I posted up your photo and it helped a woman who was in your previous situation? Hated her life, didn't want to wear clothing that she loved, didn't want to go out, didn't want to be with her man. What if that actually helped her? Because that's what I do these photos for. Don't you think that would help? And that's for all of you guys. If you ever get resistance on proof photos, say what I just said. It will help you 10 times out of 10. I've never had a client push back on me with that because we all know what it's like to struggle. And if we can help in some way, we usually end up doing, because people are creatures of like service. We want to help. We just do.
Slowly growing the YouTube, guys. So right now I am posting 1 to 2 times a day on Instagram, 1 to 2 times a day on TikTok. We are posting twice a day on Facebook, correct?
Yeah.
We're posting 2 shorts a day on YouTube. And we are trying to go ham with the YouTube videos. So we actually have a bunch of these talking head videos that we've been creating. All right, this one just went up. It's called 1 year versus 10 years of effort. And here's what it looks like, where I talk about the concept of like the recipe of success being consistency and effort times 10 years, because so many individuals are just trying to see success within like 6 months. And they're like, why am I struggling? Like, motherfucker, this life was created by 10 years of work. And a lot of people don't get that. So we're cranking out a bunch of videos like that. We're cranking out a bunch of vlogs like this. And we're just paying attention to the analytics, seeing what people like, seeing what people enjoy. We're gaining around 10 to 40 subscribers a day right now on YouTube, which is fucking incredible. I could not wish for better growth than that, other than obviously to go fucking turbo viral, but at the same time, that probably wouldn't be sustainable. So I'm happy. Right now, in the last 28 days, we've gotten 85,000 views. We've gotten 694 hours of watch time, which is fucking crazy, actually. I did not realize it. Is that 694? Jesus Christ. And we've gained 337 subscribers. It's not bad. We're doing really good. I'm very happy with the growth of it. I'm very happy with how it's going. And we're just going to keep it up. We're just going to keep it up across the board. Very male dominant on fucking YouTube compared to Instagram and TikTok. It's like almost 50-50 on TikTok. It's around 60-40 on Instagram. And it's about like 90-10 on fucking YouTube so far. So the boys are really, really showing out for me right now. So it's fucking dope. Look at my beautiful wife, dude. I should put the macros on here so I can fucking do it.
That's sweet. So sweet.
Has to do that? I'm just joking. Just talk, just start shit right away.
I'm mainly the guy that cooks.
Yeah. Fucking Julia. Let's instantly start drama. I like it. There we go. So, Julia made this chili, 15 grams of fat, 22 carbs, 25 protein. I'm gonna have it with a piece of bread. And this will bring me to probably, what is it? 900 calories left for the day.
Babe. What? I have music playing on my headphones.
Yeah.
He's just like frozen. Really? Yes. Like it's his baby music, but like he's just like, oh my God. No, like excited. Like he's just completely frozen. I'm really crying right now. What is that face?
Alright, so what's next on the agenda?
So, I definitely gotta fucking start organizing my email with my new assistant. Her name is Michelle. Super fucking excited for it. But we also have a finance meeting. So we're sitting down with our financial advisor, our CFO, Bob. So me and Brian meet with him once a month. We kind of go over what the business was doing, what our income was at, what expenses we had. And then we were able to ask any questions that might pop up in our mind about our own taxes, about what we need to do, about refinancing for our house, and just like how to fucking manage our money so we're protected and we're set up fucking properly so we don't screw ourselves in the future. Because being an entrepreneur and making cash, there's a lot of things that you need to be careful with. Like, because if you spend all your money, if you make 10K and you spend 10K, you're fucked. Because at least 30 to 40% of that, especially in Canada, goes to fucking taxes. And again, the more money you make, the more fucked you get in Canada. Just to give you guys a breakdown, I'll utilize the G-Wagon. I don't usually air out how much everything costs, but I'll do it for you guys. The G-Wagon was 230K tag on the dealership. GST, if I'm not mistaken, was 40,000. PST was another 10 to 15,000. And then luxury tax was another 40 G's right off the bat. So it was actually 300,000 to 310,000 right off, like instantly. Just to fucking drive off the lot, bro. And so we could do this meeting on a monthly basis. We're gonna dive into it right now. 18th in the morning, we all fly down. Yeah, so I'll fucking be with you for the last 3 days and then anything you fucking need, we'll drill posing, we'll drill a bunch of shit. All right, I love you. I'll talk to you in a bit.
Love you too.
Bye-bye. Bye. So Brian is looking crazy right now. It's actually funny. Like, I can always tell, like me and Brian have literally been best friends since like 2016. Like when we first met up, we like linked really well. Mid to end of 2016. So I always know when he's off and he always knows when I'm off, like based off of even texting, bro. It's like a marriage. We always joke about that shit. And then he's just going through it right now. All right. But he looks absolutely fucking amazing. This is taking this morning. 189.
Oh, right? Shit.
Leanest he's ever looked. All right. He looks so fucking good. Super proud of him. Looks absolutely amazing coming into the show. For everybody who does not know, he's competing in the Summer Shredding Championship next week. So it's on the 20th. Or the 21st, if I'm not mistaken, on the weekend. So it's gonna be absolutely amazing. I cannot wait to fly down to Houston to watch him step on stage because he's competing in the Summer Shredding Championship on the 21st or the 20th. And Janelle's competing the day before and she's gonna be doing the transformation category. So it's gonna be super dope. Daniel's gonna be coming down to film.
Yes.
And it's gonna be fucking lit. Now, obviously that meeting didn't happen for the finances. Something went down. They didn't show the fuck up. Very unfortunate, something that really pisses me and Brian the fuck off. But what can you do? All right, we just flow with the day. So now I'm gonna get fucking a monster, I'm gonna get a sweater, and then we are going to go to the gym, Daniel, because we're gonna do a meeting with our new GM who is fucking slaying, and I wanna introduce you guys. By the way, for all y'all that might be wondering, this is how the large Amarok Weekender hoodie
fits on me. I'm 170 pounds lean muscular mass at 5'6". Okay, so it's a little baggy, but it's dope.
Well, the only thing that Dustin mentioned when I completed the first invoice was that the second invoice would be sent after the event, just in case there was any overtime, so that it was the final invoice.
Okay, touche. So we'll touch on that and everything too. I gotta run into a meeting though, so can you give me all those numbers?
Yep, I'll send them over to you.
Perfect, thank you. All right, so just had a little meeting with Britzy before we go into the meeting with Iron Energy. The meeting with Britzy was to go over some of the expenses for the event. Like, people don't get it how much the events are, dude. We spent fucking north of $97,000 USD on throwing that event.
That's a
$97,000 on throwing the event. Just for the team to do the live stream, it cost $49,870. Crazy.
That is nuts.
For all of you guys that do not know, this is my gym, Iron Energy. If you don't know, you're an idiot. So how are you, big dog?
I'm good, buddy. Real good.
Introduce yourself to my blog.
I'm Brent.
Yeah.
The vlog again.
Brent.
He's our new manager. So unfortunately, we are losing Christy because she is going to Alberta to be with her family. So definitely not like a bad breakup, but a breakup, which definitely sucks. But a little bit of a blessing in disguise. I've heard that you're already making big fucking moves, which makes me very happy.
We got all our boxes over there in the corner.
Yeah.
Those are all our membership boxes. Those are gonna go out to 60 businesses tomorrow.
I like this, dude. Perfect.
That's on my shoes, that's on my shirt, that's on my collar. I hit it once, I hit it back cause I'm a baller. I told that bitch to do a trick and she said, Tada, I get a lot of guala, spend it all on.
The meeting is done.
Time to go get my fucking haircut. So I was gonna update just Daniel, but I'll update all of you guys. This is a day in the life of a 29-year-old multi-millionaire entrepreneurial fucking badass. So we did the Iron Energy meeting. Brett is our new manager again because Christy is unfortunately leaving us. I'm not gonna lie though, Brett is a fucking breath of fresh air, straight up. Christy was amazing. She's very organized, very systemized, but she didn't have a lot of gym experience. So she was able to manage mine and Brian's brains and keep everything running, which is perfect. With Brett, I was very specific. I wanted an individual that could run the fucking gym, grow it, while me and Brian aren't there. We don't have the time. We really don't. Like, I will put as much time as I can, but we don't know what we're doing. Like, we just bought this fucking gym because we wanted a gym, right? Well, Brett has managed 4 gold gyms in the past, and he's done absolutely amazing at them. In the last 2.5 weeks that we've brought him on board, he has hired 2 personal trainers and got them on commission only. He has restructured our membership pricing and our personal training pricing. He's created an onboarding / lead generation process to get us more leads, and he's kickstarted a couple different programs in Kelowna to not only bring us in more leads and more money, but to alter and impact the youth in Kelowna, which I'm very excited for. I think there's a science museum or like an aquarium. Julia looked it up and we want to bring Cade there like really bad. So we'll all do like a family trip and shit.
Cool. I love that.
Fuck yeah, bro. I love it. All right, big dog. I gotta go do your haircut. I just wanted to fucking give you an update.
Okay. I love you so much.
I love you too. I'll talk to you in a bit.
Right.
Right. Yeah, it's funny, guys. Me and Brian literally, like, no matter what, always update each other on everything. I'm like, and it's obviously because we're best friends, but what we found as business partners, like running the businesses that we do and like all the stress that comes with it, the communication that we have is what's been able to help us elevate so much. Like, people don't understand. Like, you get these fucking random entrepreneurs that are like, we're gonna start a business together. And they're like fucking, they get in bed with each other. And next thing you know, they're fucking like trying to share profits and doing stuff. And then the ego kicks in and they don't understand how to turn it off. But like, me and Brian have been doing this for so long that like, we are actually fucking family now. And we talk all day, every day. It's fucking funny. Cursed always bugs Brian and Julie always bugs me. It's like an everyday thing. But that's why we're able to see the success we've seen. Communication is key to everything.
Thank you so much for letting me take a peek.
Of course, yeah. It's dirty as shit, but look. Okay. So, all white interior and everything else, but it's dope. It rides really cool.
And what year is this one?
2020.
Word up.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, thank you so
What's your name?
It's super sick. I'm
Loran. Cool, nice to meet you.
One day.
That's Daniel,
100%.
Too.
Nice
one
to
day,
meet you,
I like that.
Affirm- one day.
Putting it into the fucking future. Years. That right there is my favorite thing in the entire world. I told Julia, like, being able to drive these cars and have people come up to me and be like,
what the fuck and ask questions and shit, like, inspire them, that's the dopest thing ever. That's why.
What's up? I'm Cam. Cam Cuts. We're at Post Barbershop.
Joyce.
Yeah, my boy. We always here.
And what's playing right now, Cam?
His music.
This is my music. Yeah, Cameron James.
Check it out. Link in description. All right, check it out. Fucking look at it. Subscribe, listen, download. Don't forget to love me.
Just say, I know what you're looking for. But you keep me coming back for more. Yeah, you keep me coming back for more.
Fucking me and Julia coming back from Vancouver. When we first got the R8, I was like, I really wanted to open it up. And we were fucking flying, dude. We were coming down the hill. Now, originally I said 200 kilometers an hour. But to think about it, I've hit 200 like multiple times in the car and it felt like nothing. Like really looking into it, like me and fucking Julia hit 300K. 300 kilometers an hour, bro, in the fucking R8.
Bro, that's fucking terrifying.
It was lit, bro.
Like it was fucking dope. All right, guys. So that basically wraps up the day. All right, the last couple things I'm gonna do are as follows. So number one, I'm going to hop into Trainerize and answer all of my Wolves Den clients, because if you guys did not know, not only am I business coach for personal trainers with PT Domination and my business partner, Brian. By the way, if you're a PT and you're struggling and you need help, get in the description, get at me. But I'm also a fitness coach and a mindset coach, all right? I have 15 clients right now just for fitness. We keep it very simple, all right? I don't really do any active lead gen for this. If people come to me, I serve them. If they don't, I don't hunt for people. And then I have 5 one-on-one elite mindset and business clients that I'm currently helping right now. If you're curious about those programs, again, get in the description. So I'm gonna answer all their messages. I'm gonna dive into it. I'm gonna upload the replay of content audits, which you guys saw me do, to the group. That's actually funny. I forgot that I made my grandma my screen background. Yeah. I forgot that I made that my screen background. It's fucking so goddamn cute, bro. And then I'm gonna shut it down. So I'm gonna review the day just so you guys get an update. But this is a pretty average day for me. All right, a pretty average day for me. It's pretty like busy like this. The only other thing I have to do is, again, answer these clients and then a little bit of content creation where I'm gonna plan out the videos I post tomorrow. I'm gonna throw up one more video tonight on TikTok, maybe something on Instagram. I haven't decided yet. I'm doing between 2 and 3 posts a day. And what I mean by that is like 2 reels, maybe an actual post, like a written post. But that's a pretty average day. So again, woke up at 3 a.m., did my morning routine. My morning routine is as follows. I'll just pop up a little text thing that you guys saw from the physique video. Then we did a workout, which you guys saw, 2 hours of boxing. After the 2 hours of boxing, I met with Josh and Janelle. Then I went to an ortho appointment, content audits. We were going to do a podcast, but I didn't. I ended up getting a little bit too backed up, but that's completely okay because I wanted to just spend time with Julia and Cade. I was supposed to do a monthly financial meeting, but again, shit happens. So that one pivoted. So I actually had a couple different calls with a couple different people in the company, Britzy and more. Our energy meeting went absolutely amazing. Then went and got a haircut, and now it's content planning time, Wolves Den planning time, and answering and packing because myself and my boy, flip the camera around for a second so you can see your face.
You don't just want this fucking,
just a single.
Oh yeah.
This is snot from my face.
There you go.
Yeah. There's literally snot coming from my nose right now.
That's funny, bro. So me and my guy here are gonna be flying to Phoenix, Arizona, actually Scottsdale, Arizona, tomorrow morning at 6 a.m. to number one. All right, hopefully meet up with the Andy Elliott boys. We met them at the Limitless event and it was fucking amazing, but primarily to do a podcast with Anthony's World. I'm super excited to meet him, hang out with his crew and deliver some motherfucking value to his podcast and more. You can check out his description below. If you guys wanna see more videos like this and you wanna see what goes into me, not only running a multi-million dollar business, but also kickstarting other businesses and training for my first boxing competition, subscribe to the fucking channel. This is episode 2, all right, of training for my first fight while operating a high level business.